Stevie, how can I help you?
More money.
You got a big show on the telly tonight. You're the number one in the charts. Have you not got enough money?
No.
All right, then. What do you propose?
You give me my own chat show.
All right, then.
Capital Cabs, where you went and picked up a bit.
Muscle Bullet. Outside my mansion.
Where are you going, friend?
New television studios, please.
Do I recognize you from somewhere, friend?
Turn on the radio.
Okay, friend.
That's me.
Sorry, friend, I never heard of that before.
Then perhaps you see me on the television last night in the comeback of one of the 90s biggest television shows.
No, I'm sorry, my friend. I've never seen that on the television, but I give it a try. I watch it next week, yes?
Don't bother. I tell me off next week.
I get it. Now I know who you are. You're the man who solved the murder of Muhammad Akram.
Indeed I am. Thank you. Goodbye, Muhammad's friend. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean those bare necessities, Mother Nature's recipes.
Wait. Camera. Action.
Good evening, one and all. Thank you very much. You're too kind. Hello, and welcome to my new show, Stephen Frame's Frame of Mind, where I'll be interviewing some of the biggest stars from around the planet. Yeah, well, for my first guest, from right here in Scotland, up-and-coming karate contender, Michael Barry. You must fancy your chances of winning this tournament, Michael. They're all children.
I really think I've got a good chance, Stevie, to be honest. Like, I really good. Have you been to the new factory? It's massive. It's absolutely massive.
unlike your chances of winning this tournament. Come back afterwards. Well, Michael, how did the final go? Oh dear. Time for a short ad break.
I'm Gary Dunn, and I win £2,500 in a football coupon every single fucking week and go marching back into work on a Monday. You two could be the same if you use Paddy Power. We've all had an accident at work, or crashed our Vespas or something at one point or another, haven't we? Was it your fault? Was it their fault? It doesn't really fucking matter whose fault it was, because you're guaranteed €250,000 if you phone the Dunn Deal Claims Company right now.
Tonight, on When Men Get Pregnant, we'll be speaking to Michael Walla from Poland, who is now 39.
Brian Seputa. Brian Seputa.
Open the gates. Open the gates. I want to go outside. Outside.
I'm building a mansion that's got 20 bedrooms and a room for 40 Vespas.
It was a piece of ages over, guys. But the Smithsonian ages just getting started. So let's get ready to fucking smash it, boys.
What a crowd has gathered here to see King Cha.
The number one security firm in Ireland, Shamrock Security. With me, Gary Dunn, the top security guard on the fucking planet. You better fucking phone them right now if you want secured.
Welcome back to this segment of the show, Chat Shit, with Ali Waldie and Gary Dunn. Afterwards, the audience will try and decide who has the most believable stories.
See the boy for Westlife. I changed his bins.
Not fucking likely. I am the boy from Westlife.
Fuck off. Man, don't talk a load of shite.
Alright, see if you remember this one.
I will have a shaggy when this one came out.
Yeah, I've squeezed all their tits. Close personal friends of mine.
Yeah, you're alright then. Suppose you shagged them too, did you?
You're fucking right I did. All four of them!
Kind of drummer's a bloke, eh?
Course I know! I got him to hold my Guinness while I shagged his sister's red raw.
Oh shit.
I'm a security guard.
I'm a top sniper in the army.
I'm the top Elvis impersonator in Ireland.
I was the star of a West End show.
Hello, I fucking wrote it!
I was Princess Diana's personal bodyguard.
I've been to a nightclub with Bono on more than one occasion. In fact, we're close personal friends.
I used to be a bare knuckle boxer. Put that big Zippo Tyson Fury in his place. Supposed to be a 12 round fight, I sparked him out in 30 seconds. Yeah, one of the gypsies were chanting, Ali, Ali, Ali. Easy.
Bare knuckle boxing? That's for faggots and pussies, is it not? I fought Mike Tyson, in his prime, in an underground car park without any rules. The only thing they brought was an ambulance because they knew Mike was going to need it when they saw Gary Dunn showing up. After I was fucking finished with him, he started singing in films like The Hangover. I fucking ended that boy's career.
I've been in space.
Space? I was in a different stratosphere when I won the tag team championships with the Legion of Doom. Then I went out drinking with Conor McGregor and the Pogues afterwards, and they told me Rangers were fucking shite.
No. Well, the results are in. That's all we have time for. Good evening, one and all. That was fucking dire. Abysmal. Brian Mack, you'll be getting better ratings than me teaching Tracy Ullman how to fucking fly fish. Who the fuck do you think you are? Letting me interview those deadbeats from my old fish factory? This is Stephen Frame's Frame of Mind, and it's celebrities, real fucking people, superstars! Get me some real fucking guests for next week, or you can kiss my ass goodbye, prick. No, I can't stand going back to the mansion tonight. I think I'll go back to my old house.
I wanna be like you. I wanna walk like you, talk like you.
Yeah, home sweet home. Look at that. Stephen Frame's rap on Andres. Stephen Frame's landline telephone. Stephen Frame's radio system. Stephen Frame's telescope. Stephen Frame's television. What the fuck? Who's that junkie smoking from Stephen Frame's bong? Oh, John, it's yourself. Don't worry, I'll leave. Feel free to use the shower, you smell like Bob Marley, just been to Amsterdam on 420. Good evening, gorgeous. How in with the Stephen Frame bomb? Thank you, you. Back at this part. Oh, gorgeous. How about a free lap dance for the world's most famous man?
No.
Well, go fuck yourself then.
I don't know which way to go. Excuse me, sir. I look for somewhere to get a curry.
A curry? Yes, indeed. You're dead in the mosque kitchen. When I head to the end of the street, you come to a venal at the end. Take a right, come back down, back the way you came, and you come to the original mosque kitchen.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Enjoy the curry.
I think it was the man who interviewed the Jake Ball and the Leprechaun on the TV.
It was a shit program. What did you just say? That's for when Brian asked me to do the knife trick. That's for when Charlie sent me to the haddock. That's when he told me to shut the fuck up. And that's for when Brian asked me why I had sleep deprivation. Oh shit. I need to get the fuck out of here.
Stevie, they're coming for you. The police are coming.
Thank you, my squeaky friend. I'll be ready. Guys, now come on! How many more? How many more?
the fuck's Gary done?